Hello, my name is Archisha Mukherjee from Kechi School and welcome back to another card making tutorial today. Today I will be creating some more Diwali cards, but these are going to be more on the modern or the quirkier side. Let's start with the first one, which is inspired by a lot of rainbow colors. For this one, I started with a pink card base and I'm going to stamp the Rangoli design from the Craft Angles Festival of Lights stamp set. And I'm stamping it directly with some black ink. I'm using VersaFine Onyx black ink. You can use any black ink that you have because I won't be coloring this image with watercolors or alcohol markers. I am next stamping this small little diya from the Craft Angles Diwali Wishes stamp set. And I'll be stamping this multiple times. And over here, I have been stamping with the Memento Tuxedo black ink because I will be coloring these images with alcohol markers, so I have to be careful that my ink is not reactive with the alcohol markers. Now you see I have colored all my diyas and fuzzy cut them and I have used the rainbow colors. Next, for the sentiment, I'm going to another old Craft Angles Diwali stamp set. It's called the Craft Angles Happy Diwali stamp set. I think this was the first Diwali inspired stamp set by Craft Angles. I'll be heat embossing this. Hence, I am stamping it first with some Versamark ink and I'll be heat embossing with some gold embossing powder. Now, I was really inspired by a wreath. You know, you see these wreath designs for Christmas cards and I wanted to do something similar for Diwali. Hence, I am using a similar kind of placement of my diyas, but I'm following the rainbow pattern or the rainbow colors. After I have carefully decided the placement of the diyas, I'm just sticking them with some foam adhesive. To bring everything together, I want to add some more gold to match my sentiment. Hence, I am adding some details with my gold pen in the Rangoli design. I'm darkening the corners of my card panel with some pink dye ink. I don't know, I felt like my card needed a little more depth and I think this gives a little more structure to the eye, like an illusion. Next, I am finally adding my card panel on my card base. You see, it's a little shorter than my card base. Not to worry, I'm just directly going to chop off the excess card base with my Guillotine trimmer. Using the Tonic Studio's Morning Dew, which dries clear, I'm adding some more design and I've also added a little more gold sequins, and that completes our first card. Moving on to the next one, which is also a very colorful card. For this one, I'm going to use the Craft Angles liquid watercolor. Honestly, I was very nervous to use this because I'm not a watercolor artist. The three shades of liquid watercolor that I'll be using is Lemon Tart, Pumpkin Orange and Poolside. And I'm not doing anything fancy. I'm just making random shapes here and there and trying to pull it a little with water. I don't know what is this exactly called as a watercolor artist, but I'm just trying to fade it from the concentrated or saturated color to into an ombre effect. I will give it a quick blow with my heat gun because I will be doing some stamping over this. And I will be stamping the image of Goddess Lakshmi from the Shubh Labh stamp set by Craft Angles. I am stamping it with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink because it does not react with watercolors. However, I would really advise to give it a quick dry after stamping because mine was wet and I smudged it. And you'll see that in the video ahead. I did manage to cover that up, but I would suggest you give it a quick dry. For my card base, I'm going to use a new Craft Angles product again, which is the gold texture based. I don't own any texture paste. This was new and I was intrigued and I had fun with it. Along with the texture paste, I'm going to use the Craft Angles marble effect stencil. I am just taping down my card base, my card panel to the back of the stencil, and then I'm going to go in with my spatula and generously spread my gold texture paste. Now the difference between a texture paste and a normal glimmer paste is that when it dries, it gives you a little rustic look. And to enhance that rustic look, I also stippled my spatula over the paste so that, you know, there are these raised peaks and valleys in my background. There you see me stippling my spatula. And that is the moment of reveal. I really love how very different this background looks from my usual card. I let the card panel dry for about 12 hours and I'm going to proceed with the card now. I have already fuzzy cut the image out. I'm just attaching some foam tape behind it and putting it directly on my panel. Next, I'll put some foam adhesive behind my card panel and put the entire panel on my card base. And I think this is the moment when I smudged it unintentionally. The next step is going to be about finding out that smudge and covering it up. That is me innocently adding some yellow Tonic Studio Nouveau drops and not realizing that there is a smudge right in the middle there near the lotus petals. And I actually plan to just add a few Tonic Studio drops with the color blue, orange and yellow and finish off the card with the sentiment and a few black strips as a frame. The sentiments are from the Happy Diwali dies, which is a new release by Craft Angles, and I have cut it out of some teal cardstock and layered it. Now, while I was just going to finish it and just showcase my card, I realized that huge blotch in the middle. So what I decided is to make this card all avant-garde, is that how you pronounce it? Anyway, to make it eccentric and fill up that lotus with a lot of dots, of colorful dots of blue, yellow and orange. And I think it is different. Many people may not like it, but I absolutely loved it. And that completes the second card for today. The third card, probably my most favorite project of this year's all the Diwali cards. Maybe the most favorite. This one is going to be an end-to-end shaker. I have been lusting after the videos that I've been seeing of the end-to-end shaker cards, and I just wanted to try them on my own. I am creating an ombre effect using the Chip Sapphire peacock feathers and salvaged patina distress oxide inks, and I'm going to add some sparkles using the Lawn Fawn liquid stardust. I've just diluted it with some water and I'm adding some splatters here and there. To give it a subtle more interest, I'm using this round lace stencil by Craft Angles. I am positioning my stencil and then attaching my card panel in a very proportionate way so that my design is right bang in the center. Next, I'm using some Lawn Fawn Yeti ink. This is a white pigment ink. I don't want to go heavy hand, so I'm just stippling my blender brush. This is the Craft Angles blender brush, by the way. Amazing. And there you have the look. It's not clean, it's rustic and exactly how I wanted it. Okay, now the end-to-end shaker card Looks easy, not very easy. Spoiled my first attempt. It was a total fail. However, with a little practice, you should be good. I'm going to stick my double-sided tape on the back of the panel on all four sides. I encourage you to use a double-sided tape and not a liquid glue, because double-sided tape will give you the optimum result. Remove the back lining paper of the double-sided tape on three sides, not on the fourth side, and just bend or fold your acetate over the double-sided tape so that it's stuck. Before I stick the last side or the third side, I'm just going to give it a quick snip so that it's easier to fold that particular panel of acetate. Also, use a thin acetate. I used a 75 microns OHB sheet so that it's easy to fold it. To make those edges more crisp, I'm just going in with a bone folder. And for my shaker elements, I'm using the Craft Angle Silver Shimmer Stars. And I think they look so beautiful when they're all reflecting light. You see, since I've just stuck my acetate on three sides, I have created a pocket. And the last step, as you've already guessed, would be the close that last side. So just pull off the backing paper and fold your acetate, and you're done. Another small tip, don't use very fine powder shaker elements, you know, those glitter powders, because the pocket is not completely sealed. There are few gaps in the corners, so bigger shaker elements won't fall out. I've got some double-sided tape at the back of my panel, and I'm sticking my panel on a white card base. The only remaining step is to add the sentiment. I'm using the Happy Diwali dies to create this Happy Diwali sentiment from some black licorice cardstock by Craft Angles. To give a dot to the eye in my Diwali, I'm using some black Nouveau drops by Tonic Studios. And that's it. The card is ready. This is freakishly easy as soon as you get the right steps for the end-to-end shaker card. That's it, guys. Those were all the three cards for today. I hope you like these different kind of Diwali cards, because I really had fun making these. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more fun videos. You can also follow me on Instagram @kenchi.school.